My brother has two birthdays. He was born on June 26th, 1984, and again on March 15th, 2015.
Muchas características que mi hermano tiene, pero la más importante es que es una persona caring.
Se iba a trabajar, me veía descobijada y me cobijaba. Y me decía, ¿necesitas algo? ¿Qué tienes? ¿Te duele algo?
Not too many brothers that come around, you know, that are like him.
Esta esclava es muy especial para mí. Porque esta mi hijo me la regaló con mucho amor y siempre la traigo conmigo, porque a mí así me siento muy conectada con él. Yo siempre estoy conectada con él, pero con esto yo me conecto más con él.
He's a good person. He's a good friend. He's a good dad. He's a good brother. A good son. Good grandkid. You know, he's just like good all around. He cares a lot about other people. Sometimes he would put other people first than himself.
It was March 15th of 2015.
Yo lo escuché cuando llegó. Llegó en la mañana, en la madrugada, y dijo, ya llegué. Y cuando yo lo escuché que dijo que ya llegó, me quedé dormida. Yo no sabía que se había ido otra vez.
Entonces yo le hice una llamada y él no me contestó. No pasó mucho tiempo cuando me llamaron de hospital.
Oscar, my other brother, he came and knocked on the door. He told me Gustavo is in the hospital. She's like, okay, he's in the hospital. And I'm like, he's been at the hospital. But then he nodded his head and he said, he's not doing good.
They had found a bullet in his brain, and we needed, some of us or a couple of us needed to go and identify if and confirm that it was him.
Adentro de mí yo quería como que no fuera él, y por eso no, que lo buscaba su cara y pues no lo veía. Tiene una cicatriz en su mano que yo conozco bien, entonces cuando yo miré su mano y vi la cicatriz, o cuando me di cuenta que desafortunadamente sí era mi hermano.
Un doctor, he just said, the person that you guys know as your brother, he's not here anymore.
Ellos querían desconectarlo. Yo les dije no. No quiero eso.
She was just like, no, you're not God. If my son's still breathing and his heart is beating on his own, then I'm gonna leave it to God. And one day we just came to the hospital to visit him, and he was awake.
Ya despertaste, bienvenido al mundo, bienvenido a la vida, le dije.
Si él volvió a nacer, como si nació por segunda vez.
Right now, he's able to breathe, eat, talk on his own, which is something that the doctor said he would never be able to do.
It's a long road, but we're gonna do our best to accomplish, you know, what we agreed to do, and that's to bring him back 100% back to his old self.
Yo sigo pensando que es la misma persona. Él está ahí y que un día él todo va a volver a ser como antes.
And one would think this is where the story ends. This is where the curtains close and I come out to you, the audience, with my brother, and he's okay. And my family's okay. And I wish I could tell you that. But he's still in the hospital. His life will never remain the same. The scars from that day will remain permanent throughout the rest of his life. And it has etched individual scars on each one of us around him in his world. No happy ending, just him, just us. Forever living in uncertainty. All the time, does it ever puzzle you? Have you asked why you seem to fall in love out again? Do
back. Look, listen to your heart, hear what it says.